Hello, welcome to netvn channel. In this video I show you how to build your own private cloud server with much larger storage capacity than other free clouds like OneDrive, Google Drive. In this example I have prepared a computer and three hard drives. A solid state drive for operating system installation. Two traditional hard drives left to store your cloud data. You can also install more hard drives to increase storage capacity if desired. The OS I use is DietPi. I use DietPi because it makes it easier for me to build a cloud server and reduces a lot of the complicated commands I have to remember. First of all, go to the DietPi homepage and download the ISO file suitable for your computer. Here I choose UEFI. Next, you use a USB stick to create the DietPi installer. The tool used to create the DietPi installer is Rufus. After downloading the Rufus tool, select the DietPi ISO file in the USB stick, then press Start. It will take a few minutes to create the DietPi installer. Once you have the DietPi installer, plug the USB stick into the target computer. Don't forget to adjust the boot order to USB storage. To avoid confusion when installing, I only installed the solid-state hard drive first into the computer. I will install two traditional hard drives later. The installation is quite simple. You just need to select the solid-state drive you want to install DietPi on and wait a few minutes to finish. After the installation is complete, your computer will automatically power off. Then you will remove your USB stick. Next, you will change the boot order of your computer to a solid-state drive with the DietPi operating system installed. This is the result when your computer has finished booting. I recommend accessing from another computer on the same local network to make the installation easier. Username is root, IP address is 10.11.32.134 and password is DietPi. I recommend you skip these options to move on to the next settings. And the software installation screen appeared. The Nextcloud app is a great choice to build a private cloud server. You can browse the list of software or type in the search box to find the Nextcloud application. You use space key to select Nextcloud application to install. You scroll to the bottom and select Install to install the Nextcloud application you just selected above. Nextcloud will take a few minutes to install, please wait patiently. I'll fast forward so you don't have to wait any longer. Try to check if Nextcloud is working or not. You open any browser, enter the IP address, slash and Nextcloud. Username is admin. Password is DietPi. You can change your password if you want. Installing Nextcloud is quite simple, right? As you can see, my cloud storage is 50 gigabytes. But for the purposes of this video, I want to increase my cloud storage even more. So I'm going to add two more traditional hard drives to increase the storage capacity. For that I will shut down the target computer with the power off command. If you are having trouble accessing remotely via SSH, delete the file as above on your computer and make access again using SSH. You use the lsblk command to check if the target computer has detected two additional traditional hard drives. Here I have seen two additional hard drives, SDB and SDC. Before using these two traditional hard drives, you need to delete all existing partitions on these two traditional hard drives. You use the fdisk command to do this. Command D to delete partitions. For SDB hard drive there are 3 partitions, so I will delete 3 times. You then use the W command to save the changes. Next I will merge these two traditional hard drives into a single partition. For that I will install LVM. You use the command apt install LVM too. Next you create a physical volume with two traditional hard drives. Something went wrong with the SDC hard drive because I haven't deleted the old partitions on it. We will use the fdisk command to delete the partitions on the SDC hard drive. Don't forget to use the W command to save the changes. As you can see, the error no longer occurs. Next you create a volume group for two traditional hard drives and name it VG0. As you can see, the capacity after pooling is about 930 gigabytes. You can merge more hard drives if your computer can install more hard drives than this. Now I will create a logical volume with all the free space above. You do the above command, this volume is called cloud and uses 100% of the free space of VG0. After creating the logical volume, one will format it as ext4. Now you need to mount it in a directory to use for your cloud. To do that, you need the UUID information of the logical volume you just created. Kid command will get you UUID information. Please write down this information to use in the next step. I will create a new folder named Nextcloud and will mount the new logical volume created in the previous step to it. You add a line in the fstab file to create the desired mount. The information includes the UUID you just obtained in the previous step. Path to the folder named cloud you just created in format ext4. For this example, the line to add should look like this. Next use the dfh command to check the results. Next you use the command mount a to mount. Next use the dfh command to check the results. So I have successfully merged two traditional hard drives into one. Next, I will use it for my private cloud. You use the command DietPi software to migrate cloud data. Scroll down and select user data location. In the list of available drivers, select the driver you just created in the previous step. It will take a few minutes to transfer the data to the new location. Now let's check if our cloud storage has changed or not. As you can see, the current storage capacity is 869 gigabytes, a huge increase from the old 50 gigabytes. If you have a larger storage capacity, your cloud storage will also be larger. The next part will help us access the private cloud from anywhere. First, you set up a static IP address for your computer. You use the DietPi config command to set up a static IP address for your computer. I will copy the current IP address into a static IP address for the computer. You can set up another IP address if you want. Don't forget to save your changes before exiting. To access from the internet, you need to forward the port on your router. Depending on the type of router you are using, the forwarding method will be different. But our goal is to forward ports 80 and 443. Port 443 I forwarded is available for the last step of this video. In this example, the IP address to forward is 10.11.32.134. You need to change the IP address to match the static IP address you set up in the previous step. To access from the internet, you open a web browser, enter the public IP address, slash and Nextcloud. That way, I can access my private cloud from the internet. But my public IP address is dynamic, so I will use DDNS service. The DDNS service I use here is DocDNS, it's free. I will create a new domain name netvncloud.docdns.org. Let's create a domain name that suits your wishes. Let's see how to install DocDNS on Linux and follow the steps. First, create a folder named DocDNS. Next, create a file named duck.sh in the folder DocDNS. You copy and paste the content as instructed. Content will include your domain name and token. Grant permissions to the duck.sh file. Next, you schedule the duck.sh file to execute as instructed. You copy and paste the content as instructed. Now let's check if the duck.sh file is working properly. Want to know if the domain is working properly or not? You can see the results from the log file. As you can see, our result is okay, then we have succeeded. Now we will access our cloud using this domain name. That way we don't need to worry about our dynamic public IP address anymore. Once we transmit data on the internet, the safety factor is very important. Therefore, we need to encrypt data when transmitting on the internet environment. To do that, you need to install certbit. Just like installing Nextcloud, you enter certbit in the search box and install it. It will take a few minutes to complete. After installing certbit, you use the command DietPi let's encrypt to set it up. Here you enter your domain name in the previous step. And you enable redirect from HTTP to HTTPS. Then wait a few minutes to complete. Now go back to your cloud, you will see HTTPS appear and your data will be encrypted when transmitted over the internet environment. That is all. Thank you for watching. If the video is useful, click like, share and subscribe to the channel. Next, you will download the Nextcloud clients on desktop, iOS and Android to access your private cloud like any other cloud application.